Hello friends, welcome to the video lecture series on digital image processing. I'm Dr. Dafda, and in this 58th video class of DIP, we'll study preview, background, image pyramids and subband coding in wavelets and multi-resolution processing. See, we have already learned JPEG 2000, which is a wavelet-based compression in video lecture number 47, and few basics of wavelet transform in the same lecture. Now we will study wavelet transforms in more detail. Starting with the name, what is the meaning of wavelet? See, wavelet is made up of two words, wave plus let. Wave means waveform and let means little or small. So wavelet means a small waveform or a ripple. So wavelet is a small wave-like oscillation or brief oscillation, we can say. And what is the meaning of transform? Transform means a mathematical model which helps to transform or change the signals between two different domains. For example, Fourier transform changes the signal from time domain to frequency domain, and wavelet transform transforms the signal from time domain to a combination of time plus frequency domain. So transform is a mathematical model for changing. Next, what is the meaning of multi-resolution processing? Multi-resolution means multiple resolution. So it provides a framework for extracting information from images at various levels of resolution. Preview means introduction. Background means history. What is image pyramid? Image pyramid is nothing but a method to display a multi-resolution image in various levels of resolution. And subband coding is a form of transform coding that breaks a signal into a number of different frequency bands. So for image processing, the image is passed through a set of bandpass filters to create a set of bandpass images or subbands. Okay, so let us start. Joseph Fourier gave us the tool of Fourier analysis, which till date is one of the most commonly used signal analysis techniques. But now a more recent transformation known as wavelet transform makes it easier to compress, transmit and analyze numerous images and signals. But unlike Fourier transform, whose basis functions are sinusoids, wavelet transform is based on wavelets. Wavelets are small waves which are mathematical functions that represent scaled and translated or shifted copies of finite length waveform called mother wavelet. So these wavelets are based on small waves of varying frequencies and limited duration. So this account for frequency and location of the frequency, whereas Fourier waves are sinusoids of infinite duration. Wavelet transform is used to analyze a signal or an image into different frequency components at different resolutions or scales, that is multi-resolution. So here we can see that in addition to frequency, these wavelets capture also the temporal or time information. And these wavelets are bound in both frequency and time domains. So these wavelets are localized waves and decay to zero instead of oscillating forever like the Fourier transform waves. So this allows revealing image spatial and frequency attributes simultaneously. In addition, the features that might go undetected at one resolution may be easy to spot at another resolution. So this multi-resolution property of wavelet theory incorporates the image pyramid and the subband coding techniques. Let us understand the differences between Fourier transform and wavelet transform. For Fourier transform, the basis functions are sinusoids of varying frequencies. Whereas for wavelet transform, the basis functions are small waves of varying frequencies and short duration. Fourier transform is used to analyze signals by converting signals into a continuous series of sine and cosine functions, each with a constant frequency and amplitude and of infinite duration. Whereas wavelet transform converts a signal into a series of wavelets. Wavelet transform basis functions are obtained by scaling and shifting the mother wavelet. So this is our mother wavelet, which is scaled and shifted. You can see here. Fourier transform will only provide the frequency information, and the time information is lost when we go from the time domain to the frequency domain or Fourier domain. Whereas wavelet transform provides both time and frequency information, which is a very important advantage of wavelet transform. During the transformation process, the temporal or time information is lost for Fourier transform. For wavelet transform, during the transformation process, the temporal or time information is not lost. Fourier transforms only provide the notes or frequency information of a musical score. For example, if you see the Fourier transform of musical notes Sa Re Gama Pa Dha Ni, it will be similar to the Fourier transform of musical notes Sa Ga Dha Re Ni Pa Ma. That means the Fourier transform of both these differently sounding waveforms will be exactly identical. And the reason for that is that the notes are sung at different times, but the frequency content in both are same. This means that in computing the Fourier transform, the time information is lost. Whereas for wavelet transform, wavelets are able to provide an image with an equivalent of a musical score, revealing not only the appropriate time to play each note or frequency, but also the notes themselves. Fourier transform removes the time information. Wavelet transform do not remove, but move it around, separating out the noise and averaging the signal. So wavelets have a very important application in noise removal, averaging, and image compression. As the name suggests, multi-resolution analysis allows us to study a signal at different scales or different resolutions. For example, a simple analogy is looking at an object from different distances. Viewed from a greater distance, a large-scale representation of the object is perceived, in which only the global or non-detailed information about the object is available. But as we get closer, the object is perceived at smaller scales and more details become available. In a similar way, a signal can also be analyzed at a different scale, where large scale deals with global information while the small scales deal with the detailed information. And remember, wavelet transform is all about multi-resolution analysis. This multi-resolution theory was first demonstrated by Mallet in 1987. Subband coding from signal processing, quadrature mirror filtering from digital speech recognition, and pyramidal image processing are just few examples of the methods that multi-resolution theory brings together. The fact that features that might go unnoticed at one resolution might be simple to spot at another resolution, making this strategy very appealing or useful. See, the objects in images are connected regions of similar texture and intensity levels. We use high resolution to look at smaller objects and coarse resolution to look at large objects. But if we have both large and small objects, we use different resolutions to look at them. See, basically images are 2D arrays of intensity values with locally varying statistics, and this figure shows that local histogram can vary over different areas of images. You can see here, this local histogram is different, this is different, this is different, as well as this is different. So it is difficult to model statistical variation over the entire image, and this is the reason why we use multi-resolution analysis. Okay, the image pyramid is a structure to represent images at more than one resolution. It is a collection of decreasing resolution images arranged in the shape of a pyramid. The highest resolution image is at the pyramid base, and as we move upward, both the size and the resolution decreases. So the base level is of size 2^j × 2^j, that is n cross n. Then we decrease it to n/2 × n/2, and it goes on up to 4 × 4, 2 × 2, and 1 × 1, that is 2^0 × 2^0, which is 1 × 1. This figure shows two image pyramids and their histograms. This one is an approximation pyramid, or we can say a low pass filter pyramid, and this one is a prediction residual pyramid, or we can say a high pass filter pyramid. And this both approximation and prediction residual pyramids are computed in an iterative fashion. So this low pass filter pyramid is also called a Gaussian filter pyramid, because a Gaussian filter is used to construct it, which we have learnt in video lecture number 19, that is image smoothing in frequency domain filtering. And this high pass filter pyramid is called a Laplacian pyramid, because the Laplacian was used to construct it, which we have learnt in video lecture number 21, Laplacian unsharp masking and high boost filtering. This Gaussian pyramid is made using downsampling, that is discarding every other sample. And this Laplacian pyramid or prediction residual pyramid is made using upsampling, that is we double the spatial dimensions of approximation images. This upsampling uses interpolation filter like nearest neighbor interpolation, bilinear or bicubic interpolation, which we have already learned earlier. Now these low resolution levels can be used for analysis of larger structures, and the high resolution levels can be used for analyzing individual object characteristics. For example, this 64×64 level is suitable to locate the window styles, which are black colored, but not to find the stems of the plant. To find the stems as well as the leaves, we have to go for high resolution. And this coarse to fine analysis strategy is useful for pattern recognition. The residual pyramid can be used to generate the complementary approximation pyramid without error if there is no quantization error. Also, the point to note over here is that the prediction residual histogram is highly peaked around zero, while the approximation histogram is not. Next and last is subband coding. As the name suggests, subband coding means band means total bandwidth or total image, and sub means part. So decomposing an image into different parts or into a set of band limited components is called subband coding. And these subbands can be reassembled to reconstruct the original image without any error. Each subband is generated by bandpass filtering the input image. As shown in this figure, the system is composed of two filter banks, S0 of N and H1 of N, each containing two FIR filters, with the impulse response of each filter and the convolution symbol written inside the block. The analysis filter bank, which includes filters S0N and H1N, is used to break input sequence FN into two half-length sequences, F low pass of N and F high pass of N. And these are the subbands that represent the input F of N. So here filter H0 of N is a low pass filter whose output is subband F low pass of N, is called an approximation of F of N, and filter H1 of N is a high pass filter whose output subband FHP of N is called the high frequency or detail part of F of N. Synthesis bank filter G0N and G1N combine F low pass of N and F high pass of N to produce F cap of N. And the goal in subband coding is to select H0N, H1 of N, G0N and G1 of N so that F cap of N is equal to F of N. This means that the input and output of subband coding and decoding systems are identical. When this is accomplished, the resulting system is said to employ perfect reconstruction filters. And this figure shows the two-dimensional four-band subband image coding. So that is all for this video class. Thank you very much.